number, right? And this alpha value will always be in between 0 to 1 because t on value cannot be greater than the total time period. Okay, so that's why this value, this V output value, will always be less than the source value. Okay, so that's why it is called step down converter. Okay, now next one is the step up converter or step up chopper. Right, now its connection is like this. Here I am connecting one inductor. Okay, now next one is one chopper, then another diode connected in forward bias, then one load. Right, so here also you will get two types of condition. First condition, when chopper is on. Second condition, when chopper is off. Okay, now when the chopper is on, then what will happen? Since this Vs is DC voltage, so in case, in ideal case, this chopper will not work. It will be just like a shorted path. Okay, this will be short circuited. This portion will be just short circuited because I am applying what? DC voltage, right? So next, hence the output voltage during the T on will be zero. Okay, now during this period inductor gets charged, right? So I can say that Vs equals to VL. Okay, so I can say also that L into di dt equals to Vs, because VL is nothing but L di dt equals to Vs. Okay, fine. So what is di? That is nothing but the instantaneous change in current. Okay, so that's why it is written as delta I. Okay, what is the instantaneous change? Look, when the current is increasing during the charging, okay, then when the switch is off, it again discharges, right? So what is your delta I? This difference is your delta I, the instantaneous change in current. Okay, or you can say it the peak to peak inductor current, because see, this is another peak when maximum current is flowing. This is also one limit when this chopper is off, right? So this delta I, and this delta I is flowing for what time? For only T on condition, because for T off, no, right? So delta I divided by T on equals to Vs by L. So from here, delta I value you just calculated. That value is Vs by L into T on. Okay, now when the chopper is off, then what will happen? When the chopper is off, look, chopper is now off. Okay, so all the current will go through this load, because when the chopper is on, this will create a shorted path. When the chopper is on, okay, okay, let me direct it in another way. This one is the first case when chopper is on. This one is the shorted path. But when the chopper is off, this, through this path, no current will flow. Okay, so the longer path it has to take. Okay, now apply your mesh analysis rule. You will see that this V0 value is the addition of Vs plus VL, because negative to positive, so gaining of potential, and here also negative to positive, gaining of potential. So that will be Vs plus VL. Right? Then similarly, when DI, what is your instantaneous current then? That is delta I. It is known to you. And it is happening for what time period? What is the value of DT then? The DT value is your T of, because this total incident is occurring during the T off. Clear? So now I can write that L into del I by T off equals to V0 minus Vs, because VL equals to L DI DT. Correct? So from here, delta I equals to V0 minus Vs by L into T off. Now from here you are getting delta I value. And from the previous, you also got a delta I value, and they must be equal. Okay, so you have to equate it. So from here, you will find out that this is your output voltage. That is V0 equals to Vs divided by 1 minus alpha. V0 equals to Vs by 1 minus alpha. Okay. And this alpha value must not be greater than 1. Okay. So from here you will see that if your alpha value, if this alpha value is 0.2, you will get V0 value which is greater than Vs. Okay. Take one example. Suppose your Vs value is 10 volt, okay, T on equals to 5 second and T off equals to 15 second, okay. So what is your alpha value? That what is your duty ratio? That is 1/3, right, 5 by 15. Now, if this chopper system is acting as step down chopper, then when it is step down chopper, then what will be your output voltage during step down condition? V0 equals to alpha into Vs. Okay, so you will find out the V0 value as 10 by 3 volt, that means 3.33. okay, now if this system is applicable for step up chopper, then what will be the output value? V0 equals to Vs divided by 1 minus alpha. Okay, so I can say that Vs value is 10 divided by 1 minus 1/3. So that means 2/3, right? So 10 divided by 2/3. So your value will be 15 volt. Okay. So what is your output now? What is your average output? That is greater than the source voltage. So that's why it is called step up chopper or boost converter. Right.
Sir.
What are, yes?
Sir, alpha is T on by T or T off, sir?
T alpha equals to, that means your time ratio equals to T on time divided by total time period. Total time period. Okay.
Here will be 1 by 4, sir, alpha.
Where? Okay. Sorry. It is T off written, na? Okay, yes. Then this will be also wrong. Then your total time period is 20. Very good. Your total time period is then 20, right? So your alpha value will be 1 by 4.
Yes.
Exactly. Right. Very good. So this alpha value here will be 1 by 4. That means this system's value will be 2.5. Okay. And here this value will be 1 by 4. So it will be 3 by 4. So 40 by 3. Right? this value will be 40 by 3. So value will almost become 13.33. Okay. So that's how you have to solve the numericals. Okay. And the previous 2 years question I already uploaded in Google Classroom. So you can now solve that. Okay. Okay. Just a minute. Take a look whether I have that or not. Just a minute. Okay. No, it is not here. Just a minute. Where was that question?
Hello, welcome to the Complete Web Design Bootcamp 2020. My name is Satya. HTML is used to build skeleton of the... Thank you.
Okay, JK, is the question paper visible?
Yes, sir.
Yes, sir.
Okay. So, this one was the numerical. Yes, this one. See, if a DC-DC buck converter of input voltage V has chopping frequency F,
welcome back, guys. And in this lecture, we are going to discuss about the introduction of HTML.
DC-DC buck converter. That means
that's the beauty of HTML. Thank you.
Down converter. Okay. So in case of step down converter, what is your
child
output
element.
Voltage alpha?
So for the HTML, head
voltage,
and body
yes.
are called as the
what
child
is the
elements.
Value of alpha? Alpha value is T on by T. Okay, T on by T. Now what is frequency? Frequency equals to opposite of time. Frequency equals to 1 by T, right? So from here I can write F into T on into Vs. Okay, so that is the correct answer. So check which value you will get from here. F into T on. Okay, there are two correct answers. Look, F into T on into V and another F into T on into V. A and D, both are correct. Okay, clear. Okay, now the last one is the advantage of the power electronic converters. Number one, mass production, because since they are semiconductor devices, so just by automation technologies, you can mass produce it. Okay, now highly reliable, because you can control it as your wish. Okay, what is your output requirement? Based on that, you can calculate it. And there is no moving parts, right? Since there is no moving part, so your frictional loss is very low. Frictional loss is zero here. Okay, next, highly efficiency. Negligible maintenance, because once it is once you are using this kind of devices, the maintenance cost is totally low, totally zero. Okay, then it faster response, right? So these are the advantages of the power electronic converters. Now what are the disadvantages? Disadvantage is the production of harmonics. Okay, harmonics means, suppose this is your frequency. Okay, some multiple frequencies inside the base frequency is also produced. Okay, this is due to some noise. Right, so these are called basically harmonics. Their magnitudes are low, but if your harmonics amount is higher, then your loss will be high. Okay, so that is the main problem, and it will also create some amount of vibration also in the device. Next is the low power factor. Its power factor is very low. Okay, next, the low overload capacity. If instead of 5 volt you just apply 5.3 volt, the device will burn immediately. Okay, so that is the disadvantage for using this kind of devices. So if it is rated at 5 volts strictly, then you have to apply, or you must apply 5 volt exactly. Okay, so that is the disadvantage. These three are the main disadvantages for using the converter. Okay, so that's it. With this, I am concluding today's class. And if you have any query, you can ask. And all of you give your attendance in the chat box. Thank you.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.